going to be like Joni Mitchell at one of David Crosby's parties. Now, everyone, I don't know the story. I think the real cover got, like, banned by... But we all know this is really the cover. It says Bob Dylan on there somewhere. And if you've seen my band Glue in Connecticut the last 3 years or so, I usually borrow Peter Grennan's guitar, a Tele, that has this on the guitar. It's pretty cool. And of course, the best picture, again, like yesterday, is the inside. And we could see Mr. Richards at the Beggar's Banquet, right here, handing Mr. Jagger an apple. Brian's looking like barely there over there. Wyman's just whatever. And then Charlie, as always, looks a little bored and a little unimpressed. Yeah. Anyway, Melissa got me this. It's the deluxe edition, and it has like an extra album in there. And I honestly don't think we've listened to that. Anyway, the beginning of the Stones' golden years of perfection. All right, I'm only going to play the first half of this because I still have not gotten the end down. So it'll give me something to strive for. Maybe by next week I'll have the ending down. And for this song, I'm not reading it, but I will be using... You know you're having a good practice when your metronome runs out of juice and you have to rewind it, right? Little one click faster. Here we go. This is for all you Tenenbaums fans out there. Of this board that your client requires further rehabilitation until he is deemed able to re-enter society. It's such a simple song, but man, it's got chords like this in it. I don't know what to call that for all you chord heads. It's D, G, B, E. 6-2 of a D chord? That's messed up, man. I could learn that on guitar. I got free time, right? What would it be? Mm-hmm. Notice that it's not in the same key. That's because I have my detuned 1964 Gibson. And where is it? There's the Gibson. It's a little dusty, isn't it? This is a beautiful guitar that never leaves the house. And my friend Albert set it up for me a couple years ago. It broke, the headstock broke once because my parents knocked it over while they were setting up the Christmas tree. And they said, well, don't leave your guitar sitting out. And they were right. Thanks, Judy. Sailing hard ships through broken harbors out on the waves in the night. Still the searcher must ride a dark horse racing along in his stride. Tell me why. Tell me why. Mostly in tune. It's in tune enough for a Neil Young song. No offense, Neil. No offense, hey. All right, well, I got some goofy songs ready, but, dude. Oh, speaking of the dude. All right, see, I try and plan songs ahead of time, but it's really more fun to just wing it, don't you think? Don't you find, Mr. Hughes? Because Loops just said, dude, reminds me of the dude. I do two songs from that soundtrack, and perhaps I'll play them both today. La 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 la
with a woman like your kind. Find the lady but oh, what a wonderful feeling just to know that you are near. No, it bends my heart feeling from my toes.
Cheers, everyone. What's up, Lauren McConnell? Lauren McConnell is my divorce attorney. Right? Beat that. Dan, I'm not going to play that today because there's a reason, but I'm not even going to tell you the reason. But you'll find out if you tune in. Hey, Rob Madsen, lead guitar extraordinaire. He plays with my main project here in Boise, Buddy DeVore. Rob is the lead guitarist, and he's like fluid, flawless, beautiful guitar player. Where I of course play upright bass. What's in the glass? Well, it's mostly fermented potatoes, I think, which I was actually debating if I was going to have to make my own booze, maybe start a still out in the shed. I can't do Hallelujah. It's on my do not call list. Sorry. What was I going to say? Oh, and Lauren McConnell, my divorce attorney, is also a kick-ass singer. Like, she can, like, wail. So I hope you're singing these days, Lauren. All right. So, let's see. I had a request for Had to Come Over, which I played last week, but it feels like a long time ago. Nice, little Boise reference there, Scotty. Anyway, this is an original, and I played it on piano last week, which I was a little over my head, so I'm going to do it on guitar. Maybe I was wrong. Could be alright. You're the one who said as we never fight. Once you made it, it's never the same. Now I've been alone with shame. But I had to come over, make things right. It's the same good, no good things. we tune the guitar. Why don't you tune it like beforehand in the beginning? Just pick it up for the first time of the day and just like think it's going to magically be in tune. And that's not how the world works, people. I got a fever for a Flight of the Conchords. Yeah, yeah, we'll do that. Oh. What was I going to say? Oh, Richard Solis. I saw his like come by. I don't know if you're still watching, but Richard is a Boise. He's one of the greatest guitar players I've ever heard. And it's not because he does anything crazy or fancy. It's because he has feel that's unmatched. And my favorite Richard Solis is when he's playing solo and he's playing a song, regular song, does it. And then in between songs, he doesn't know what song to play, so he just starts going like... It starts like improvising these like symphonies, and it's really cool. Anyway, Don't Be Gone. Yeah, we'll do that one. Powderhorn, Powderfinger. All right, what do I got? Flight of the Conchords. Oh, more metal. Ah. Metal, but for someone like me, this is metal. There is unrest in the forest, there is trouble with the trees. Mother maples won't cross the light, the oaks ignore their pleas. The trouble's with the maples, and they quite convince their right. Say the oaks are just too lofty, and they drag up all the light. And the folks can't help their feelings, if they like the way they're made. But they wonder why the maples can't be happy in their shade. Something like that.
us too greedy. We will make them give us light. And now there's no more for confession. They passed an open law. And the trees are all kept equal by hatchet, axe, and saw.
The drummer simulates cutting down of trees in the interlude there. It was a real sad moment in my life when I wrote down the words to that song in high school on a piece of paper, and my sister found it, and she was like, "Holy God, did you write these lyrics?" And I was like, "No." And by the way, screw Ayn Rand. And yeah, I say Ayn, not Ayn, or whatever you're supposed to say. I love Neil Peart, but I'm not a big fan of Ayn Rand and his whole, well, let's not go off on a rant. Let's just play some more tunes. How about that? What do you think, Melissa? All right, what was the other request? That's metal. That's as close as I get to metal, dude. Okay. Flight of the Conchords, yes. And then what was the other one? Don't Be Gone, Powderfinger. Okay, yeah. I haven't played this song in a while. And Flight of the Conchords, like that one year, everyone seemed to know this song. But now I play it and people are like, what the hell is that? Anyway, I'll try. Heck yeah. Looking round the room, I could see that you are the most beautiful girl in the room. In the whole wide room. If I saw you, and when I saw you in my mate's place, I said, man, what is she doing at my mate's place? How did Dave get a hottie like that to a party like this? Good one, Dave. You're a legend, Dave. I saw you standing all alone by the stairwell.
No, it's not out.
And if I saw you on the street, you would definitely be in the top three good-looking girls on the street. Wide street. I see you standing all alone by the stereo. Turn the light down very low. Don't you know you're so beautiful? You could be a waitress. You're so beautiful. You could be a part-time model. Turn the lights down, here we go. I don't know, I'm missing, something's missing. It's 12:02, just me and you, and seven other dudes looking around us on the dance floor. I'll draw you near, let's get out of here. Let's get in the cab, I'll buy you a kebab. I can't believe that I shared a kebab with the most beautiful girl that I have ever seen with a kebab. Why don't we leave? Or we could go to my house or we could beat each other up on the couch. Oh no, I don't mind taking it slow. No, no, cause you know, you're so beautiful. Like a tree, so beautiful. Or a high class prostitute, you're so beautiful. You could be a part time model. Although you probably have to still keep your day job, a part time model. Spending all your time modeling and part of your time.
Jeannie, Jeanette. It's good, Jeanette. I was just going to say, it's good, Jeanette. We used to have a circle of friends where the name Jeanette had a long, had a big bad footprint on the psyche. So when we would talk about this Jeanette, they'd be like, Jeanette! And no. Good Jeanette. I'm sure bad Jeanette was a perfectly nice person. I never got to hear her side of the story. Alright. What was it? Powderfinger? Helplessly hoping is not always the most fun solo song. Exit stage left. Yes. That was my jam. Lawyers, Guns, and Money's not gonna happen. Sad Songs and Waltzes, you got it. Okay, I'm just looking at my requests over here. The Triangle. Rest in peace, Neil, yeah. Alright, I don't know War on War, that's got a bunch of lyrics. I love that song, though. Alright, so we got Powderfinger, Don't Be Gone, and, Yeah, you were. What are you gonna do, Scott? It's a journey, isn't it? I forget what I was going to do. Let's see Don't Be Gone, because it's an original. And if I don't do originals, what the hell am I doing here? I did this early in the week, and I got some of the words. I got the majority of the words. And there's a lot of words, so if I skip a verse or two, like, does anyone really care? It's like, we get the idea song. I still cried over you. Huh. Fair enough. Equality 7 to... I don't know what that means. Hey, there's Rob Malavi. For those of you that don't know, he is a lead singer in a Zeppelin tribute band. And let me tell you, they do not disappoint. You guys should all go see them. Black Dog, not now, of course, but Black Dog, the ultimate Zeppelin tribute, playing in the tri-state area and beyond. And, dude,
he can just do it.
It's not like he's screaming. He just, like, hits the notes. Music store guy, I don't know. Sad Songs and Waltzes is next. For sure. But, Spill. Get very funny, Steve. There's like a song I wrote and played like 3 times, and then it was like, oh, this song isn't really good. So then it died. So it's dead. I don't even remember the. No. That is not. First of all, oh, exit stage left. All we knew was the trees and Xanadu. I'm not gonna do that one now, but no, you threw your wallet and keys at us when we played Dogs by Pink Floyd. And we did the whole, that whole solo part. I think that, although I was, because mushrooms, yeah. My recollection might not be as good either. Maybe it was the Rush set. I think it was Dogs by Pink Floyd, though. Because I remember being like, what just hit my ankles? And it was like, oh, he threw his wallet and his keys at me. Anyway, does it really matter? Okay, Willie Nelson. That same night, I remember Craig Summey told a story about his friend's parents. They were on vacation and... the wife was posing for a picture under a palm tree, and the top of the palm tree like broke off and fell on her. And he's like, dude, and she ruptured her spleen and she broke her hip. And then he said, she was maimed. I mean, it's not funny for that lady, but the way he used the word maimed was just, she was maimed. I'm writing a song all about you. A true song is real as my tears, but there's no need to hear it. No one will fear it. Sad Songs and Waltzes are selling this year. I'll tell all about. Thank you. Still tuning. All right. Let's see. Notice is not going to be played. Any Bob Morley? Morley? Yeah, I met this guy once. And he was like, I love reggae. It's my favorite kind of music. But Bob Marley stinks. That never happened. Nobody ever said that. All right. Let's do, what was it? Oh, Bob Marley, yeah. Well, I sort of know some of them. Oh, Hometown Death Trap. I don't think I remember the lyrics to that. I'll try it, though. All right, let's do the Bob Marley. Which one is it? It's the one that goes like this. All right, let's see. This is the only one I ever really sing. I don't know if I'm going to remember it at all. Cold ground was my bed last night. Rock was my pillow too. Rambling after that. It's pretty cool though. It's cool when he does it. Not if I was to do it. I don't wanna be down anymore. I can't remember the chords to that song, Scott. You know what? I'll figure it out maybe for tomorrow. How about that? Song at all. What are you gonna do? You can't keep them all. Some of them you gotta throw back. Sometimes you gotta shoot your own dog. Sorry. I'll do Angelina. Wishnog 2 is absurd. Flight 1016 I'm not gonna do today, and for a good reason, but I don't want to give it away why. But there's a good reason why I'm not going to do that song today, among others. So, Sticks and Stones. And I'm not going to do It's Better When You're Not Around either for the same reason. But I'm not going to say why, and I'll let you speculate as to why. I'll do Angelina, though. This requires an in-tune guitar. Thank you. I don't know any Holly songs. I was never moved by them.
Hey, Carrie Ann, tell me your game. But I really don't know how to play.
Carrie Ann was Marianne Faithful, by the way. Spoiler alert. Yeah, Sticks and Stones. Sticks and Stones, is it really even a song? I'll play it now.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but they'll break yours.
Still haven't figured out John's little. That was it. It was a. So at the end of the song, we'd all get a little break. So we go. That's the drummer's break. So when John Alexander got his. When John would get his little break, he'd do this. Pretty cool. Yeah. It's a big capo day. This is my third capo song. Is that allowed? Capo regime.
Take me to the station. Put me on the train. I've got no expectations. Again. Get that shit off my feet.
This isn't a good slide guitar, people. The action's too low. No one always says how Brian Jones was great at slide. I thought he was terrible, but that was near the end. Maybe he was, he had health problems. A couple of these I'll do, but not all of them, Scott Smith. I'll do I Wish I Was High. Just a lot of tuning to it. Some days the guitarist just doesn't want to get out of bed, you know. It's like the tuner's telling me, yeah, your B. There we go, okay. Sing me back home. Merle Haggard. No. Second here. Huh. All right. Send this one home. Tell them I've forgotten what the past was like. Only know the future of the moment that just passed me by. And I wish I was high. Not here on the ground with all this thinking, but up there in the clouds with no decision. No decision. I wish I was high. It's too late. I try to change my mind into me. It's confusing when what's right isn't always what is real. And I wish I was high. Up there in the clouds with no distractions. Send this one home. Tell them I remember every promise. They felt just as empty as I do today. I wish I was high. Somebody asked, buddy. Oh yeah, Jesus, etc. What a weird title. Is there any other songs with the title with etc. in the title? don't cry. You can rely on me, honey. You can provide anything you want. I'll be around. You arrive about the stars. Each road is a setting sun. Tall buildings shake, voices escape, singing sad, sad songs. Tune to chords, strum down your cheeks, bitter melodies, burning you more than alone. Don't cry, you can rely. Professional violinist that played that with me. That was awesome. What was her name? Phil Smith will know. Stop asking for notice. I don't know how that goes. I have no idea how that goes. Notices. I have no idea. And yeah. Pete Townsend songs. Rebecca, yeah, she was like really good. She did all the little plucky parts too. Oh no. Sorry, Dan. Dan hates Wilco. What did they do to you? Because to me, Wilco is a very uncontroversial band. Like, they're not my favorite band, but I like them. But they're very like, they're just palatable, you know, they're not like offensive, you know. You either love the Sex Pistols or you hate them, but Wilco, they are not. The Sex Pistols, they are not. Oh, Dan, I've seen the online madness. All right. I'm not going to do Pluto again for a while because I, you know, you can't tell the same joke over and over, you know what I'm saying? Thank you.
Take my hand and come hither now. Close your eyes. Does frustration leave you all in a dither now? Don't be surprised. Try and see what you don't see. Smell its taste.
Sped up the tape at the end, just for fun. So, Jim, it's a B flat minor with the minor third in the bass, so it's a. B flat. That's a weird little chord there, so yeah. Actually, he capos 5 for Jesus, etc. So it's really C. It's like a F minor guy there. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. Oh. All right, Mama tried on banjo. It's like, now you're being ridiculous. The banjo's just sitting back here like a potted plant, waiting for someone to, well, treat it like a normal human being. All right, I'm gonna put my cabbage on here. Cups and cakes. Seven cups and taking cups and cakes with me and cakes with me. I love cups and cakes. You know what else is great in Listen to the Flower People? If you listen, there's a whole version of that song. And listen to what the flower people say. Listen, it's getting louder every day. Anyway, the second verse, which isn't in the movie, goes, listen, it's like a Mozart symphony. Listen. Yeah, anyway, it's fun. Underrated tap, yeah. Oh, my favorite Spinal Tap story is that I'm going to have to do it. I'll do that one. My sister saw Spinal Tap live in their comeback tour in the 90s. Break Like the Wind was the name of the album. And she said they did Stonehenge. And sure enough, in the middle of the song comes and everyone's ready and it was the right size. Stonehenge. Triptych. And it was like, well, it was really funny if you were there. All right, what is this called? I'm gonna have to do it. Out of town, you're gonna have to break my heart. be the hardest part, and it's time for a brand new start. Gonna have to do it. Gonna have to make a new plan. Gonna have to do it. Some other man. You're gonna have to break my heart. Should've known from the start. It's your life and it's over for this fall. Yeah, this is fun. It's nice to connect with everybody, even if it's for, you know, for a bad reason. It's lovely in its own way. Let's see. What I got here? I'm not doing that song. Who's kidding who? People have spoken. I guess I'll play this on piano. I'll do the same song I was going to do. Might be a little sloppier. Thank you. most? How about most of the words?
Yeah.
Murder most foul. Yeah, yeah, that's some paragraphs right there. Do you want to do the thing? Mm-hmm. You want to do that song?
Sure.
I think we have a special guest. I think she's special. What's the origin key gonna be? Ladies and gentlemen, Melissa. Oh, sorry, Dan. This is another Wilco song.
He's probably already left.
I know. Well, I deleted his comment because he posted a whole big rant against Wilco, so I deleted it.
Oh, he has a right to express.
This is a fun. This is.
I'm sure it was all in good fun, Dan.
No, he's a ranter. That's why I love him.
You shouldn't delete his comments.
Do you want to start it?
Sure.
Well, this is predominantly a cello player, so this is like, I think she did really well. What do you guys think? Tell us in the comment section. Summer Teeth. Woo! Oh, that's very sweet.
Sorry, not, Dan.
It's not sweet at all. Okay. How to fight coronaliness. Will you make a speech, Melissa?
About what?
I don't care. I want to fill my cocktail. Hang in there, people. I'll be right back. Dead air.
This is not my show.
Dead air. I think Melissa did great. What do you guys think? This is for Warner Brothers. What's this? After the hours I spent holding up her poster with one hand. This guy's pretty good. Oh, what do you got on there?
On what?
That's a me on the computer, but it's obviously not live.
You're now walking away from the...
All right. Sorry, folks. Sorry for that unprofessional incident. But, you know, once I go past the hour and a half point, you know I have needs too, right? Back door slam. All right. You got it. Oh, there's multiple requests. Woo! Well, I come home in morning. I've been working all night. I heard that sound that I knew someday it might. I heard my back door slam. I heard my back door slam. Was it enough pain? Why'd I hear my back door slam? Well, you can call me the devil, you can call me a fool, but you crossed that line when you broke that golden rule. Why'd I hear my back door? Why'd I hear my back door slam? Was it another man? Why'd I hear my back door slam? Why'd I hear my back door? Why'd I hear my back door slam? Was it another man? Why'd I hear my back door slam? Melissa does a great job with that one. We're still like in the early stages of tweaking her set of music because I think she has like a very wonderful singing voice. So we're trying to find the right tunes to showcase them. But you know. Oh yeah, no, I didn't do the note. Okay, so here's the note. Did I tell the story? I'm gonna tell it again. So in the outtakes. They're playing that song. And Leroy Bach is the piano player. They show him. The guitar player goes. And it's like, it's not really. It should be. And they just show Leroy playing his piano. He hits that one note and he looks up for a second and he goes back. I'm sure. I guess, did I already tell that story or? Anyway. It doesn't matter, does it? All right. All right. Which of these would I prefer to play? That's the question. Oh, it's a cat. Come on, give him a little airtime.
I don't think he wants airtime.
Well, he doesn't know. This cat's name is Blue, but it's B-L-U, all capitals with an exclamation point in his name. See? Look at him. He's all fluffy. He doesn't know. He doesn't know what a camera is. He's just confused. Oh, he just got flipped up there, upside down. All right, I think, no, I never learned that, Scott. It's a lot. Sit on my face, tell me that you love me. Look into your eyes with your head between my thighs. No, it's a Python song. I don't actually know, but. All right, what was I going to play? Oh, yeah. This is the best overdose scene in cinematic history, and this song goes with it. It's such a perfect day. Make sangria in the park. Later when it gets dark, we go home. Such a perfect day. The animals in the zoo. And later a movie too. I used to know one, and Ocean Spring? You mean Ocean... Ocean Spray. Ocean Spray. Melissa won't drink that. It's all sugary, bad cranberry. She gets the natural stuff. Right, Melishk?
Yeah.
See, you hear that? She's still here. She hasn't fled the house. I was going where I shouldn't go. Being what I shouldn't see. Being what I shouldn't be. Being who I shouldn't be. A little voice told me it was all right. A little voice told me it was wrong. Songs. They were just good enough to be believable, but not good enough to actually be hit songs, so they were perfect for the fictional movie, you know? Yeah. Alright, this is another original request, so hey, I'm gonna do it. voices are calling out to you. How music is supposed to sound. Alright. I'm gonna do one more song. Simon's obviously getting. Can you hear him? Simon. Oh, there he is. Look at this beautiful cat. He's so confused. Not just now, I mean, just in general. All right, one more song, and this again is a request for an original. And for those of you that are not familiar with borborygmus, it's the medical term that describes the sound of intestinal rumbling. That is Simon, yes, the mournful howl. So this is borborygmus. I don't know where I first learned that term, but I immediately was wanted to write a song with that title. So here we go. Is that how it goes? How does it go? Oh, there it is. I had the wrong notes. I haven't eaten for a week now. Borborygmus ringing in my ears. I had a pretzel and a peanut and a beer and a beer and a beer. I've been out just tavern prowling. Now I fear my stomach's growling. I have to fill it up with that which didn't come from hops or a grape. Peristalsis that drew me, borborygmus ringing in my ears. take the time and don't be tardy. I'll see you at the after party. I know you're starved, but don't you worry. We could spit in order of Chinese. Parasolsis rolling through me. Over Igmas ringing in my ears. Thanks, everybody. I love you guys. I look forward to this every day. I saw dibs riding on your mom. Look forward to this every day. So thanks for tuning in and keep the requests coming. I think tomorrow, I'm not going to do this tomorrow. And there's a reason, but I can't tell you. But anyway, I'll be back on Saturday with a vengeance, okay? So cheers, everybody. Thanks for the requests. Thanks for just being here with me. That's all it is. We're just all hanging out virtually, and it's wonderful. It's better than shock therapy, okay? So thanks all y'all. Hope you're all hanging in there. I love you guys. And I'll see you next time. It'll be in 2 days instead of one, but otherwise every day, but not tomorrow.